Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. Today in this video we will learn some more important points regarding the lesson Settlements Migrations from the 10th class social studies textbook. Migration. People moving from their places to other places in search of better opportunities is called migrations. Migration arises out of various social, economic, or political reasons. Measure and classify migration patterns. For identifying a person as a migrant, two criteria are used by the census. They are birthplace, place where the person was born. Last usual place of residence, a place where the person had stayed continuously for a period of 6 months or more. In India, according to the census 2011, about 307 million people have been reported as migrants. Migrations can happen due to many reasons. While females report marriage as the most common reason for migration, employment or seeking employment is the most common reason for males to migrate. Dissatisfaction with employment opportunities in the native place, better opportunity for studies, losses in business, family fears, etc. are also some of the other reasons that people have stated as reasons for migration in the census surveys. Seasonal and temporary migration. According to the National Census Surveys, every fourth person in India is migrant. Rural to rural migration is increased. Some of this may not be captured by census data because the period of stay is often less than 6 months. Rural to rural migration. Maharashtra is one of the popular states of India which produces sugar. It has 186 cooperative sugar factories. Large-scale sugarcane cultivation began here in the early 1970s after the Koyna Dam was built. A study estimates that about 650,000 laborers migrate from central to western Maharashtra for sugarcane cutting each year. Of these, around 2 lakhs are children in the school age group of 6 to 14 years. They come with their family members. The National Commission of Rural Labour, in its report in 1990s, found that uneven development and regional disparity triggered and accelerated seasonal migration. Rural to urban migration. People migrate from rural areas mainly due to insufficient employment opportunities and inadequate income available in rural employment. People also migrate with the expectation of higher income and more opportunities for family members and maybe better services. Many move to urban areas more out of desperation and not having adequate employment opportunities in the rural areas. These people are not able to find jobs in the organized sector. International migration. 1/3 of the world's 200 million international migrants, less than 70 million people according to the United Nations Development Program, have moved from one developing country to another. International migration from India is of two types. People with technical skills and professional expertise have migrated to countries such as USA, Canada, United Kingdom, Australia, and other developed countries. IT professionals, doctors, and management professionals are an example of this type. Indians migrating to countries such as UK and Canada in 1950s and 1960s were unskilled, whereas in the later years, mostly professionals went to these countries. In recent times, Indian professionals also go to countries such as Germany, Norway, Japan, and Malaysia. In the 1950s, about 10,000 persons a year went to developed countries, and in 1990s, this has increased to more than 60,000 a year. The second type of international migration is unskilled and semi-skilled workers migrating to oil exporting countries of the West Asia on temporary contracts. During the last few decades, Saudi Arabia and UAE have been the important destinations for most of the 3 million Indian workers in the West Asia. Every year, more than 3 lakh workers migrate to West Asia. Nearly 3/5 of workers going to West Asia are from Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, and Andhra Pradesh. A considerable section of these workers are engaged in construction projects, maintenance, services, transport, and telecommunications. What happens when people migrate? Migrants who are unskilled and perform manual labor often face many hardships in their countries of work. Migrants are not able to access various health and family care programs as they do not belong to the organized sector. Migration leaves a considerable mark on the migrants also. Exposure to different environment, stress associated with it, food available, and social atmosphere leave a deep impact on migrants. In some regions of India, nearly 1/3 of households depend on the remittances sent by their migrant members. Monitoring of international migration. The Immigration Act 1983 is the Indian law governing migration and employment of Indians abroad. It also lays out conditions to safeguard the interests of workers emigrating for employment. Embassies set up by the Indian government in different countries are expected to follow the legal procedures and protect the welfare of the international migrants as given in the Immigration Act. To get a notification of our further videos, make sure to subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching our videos.